Hello, my name is Eddie DePandy, and I'm a consultant here at Velosio on the Data Platform Services team. Today, I'll be walking you through some tips for mastering year-over-year analysis in Power BI. In this session, we will cover the following topics: understanding year-over-year analysis, setting up your data and implementing proper formatting in Power BI, creating year-over-year measures using DAX, visualizing year-over-year comparisons, and best practices and tips. Year-over-year analysis is a method of evaluating two or more measured events to compare the results at one time period with those of a comparable time period on an annualized basis. It's commonly used to assess business performance, sales growth, and other key metrics. Power BI is a great tool for reporting year-over-year KPIs, or key performance indicators, to be consumed by business stakeholders. For today's example, we will focus on evaluating sales growth. Here in Power BI Desktop, I have a sample data set that includes our sales data, our date table, which will allow us to filter our sales data by order date, and a few dimension tables that will allow us to further filter our results by customers, stores, and products. A key thing to note is that a date table is required when working with data analysis expressions, otherwise known as DAX, time intelligence functions that we will leverage to calculate our sales amounts. In the model view, you will want to ensure that your date table is marked as date table. To do this, click the three dots at the top right of the date table and select mark as date table. On the right side of our model view, we have two measures tables: base measures for our standard calculations, such as sum of total sales, and a transformed measures table for our time intelligence calculations that will incorporate measures from our base measures table. Now, let's create our year-over-year measures using DAX. The first measure we need is the total sales or any metric you are analyzing. For example, if we are analyzing sales, we would create a measure like this, calculating the sum of net sales from our sales table to give us our total sales. Leveraging our total sales measure, next we will create our previous year sales measure. To do this, we will use the calculate function for total sales, filtering on the same period last year from our date table. The same period last year DAX function outputs values that are shifted back 1 year based on a specific date period. Next, we have our year-over-year sales growth measure, dividing our total sales minus our previous year sales by our previous year sales to get our percentage of growth. Notice I've selected the percentage format in the formatting pane to allow my value to be displayed on my report visuals as a percentage rather than a decimal number. With our measures ready, let's visualize the year-over-year comparisons. We'll start by adding a few slicers to our report page to filter our data. At the top, I will add a date range, customer name, product category, and store state. I will filter our date range from January 1st through December 31st of 2019. We can use a line chart or a bar chart to represent the data. Select the line chart visual under the visualizations panel, as I have already done here. Drag the date column to the x-axis, add the total sales measure to the y-axis, add the previous year sales measure to the y-axis. For our year-over-year growth measure, we can either add this to our line chart by adding it to the secondary y-axis. The secondary y-axis adds an additional y-axis range on the right side of the chart, which allows for a better display of your data when including numeric and percentage amounts on your visual. For an even cleaner look, we can move the year-over-year growth measure to the tooltips, which allows us to see the percentage change by hovering your cursor over the lines on your line chart. Our sales data is comprised of multiple transactions spanning multiple days in a month. By structuring your date table to include additional date fields, such as month-year, based on the date, we can format our line chart to evaluate our year-over-year sales on a monthly basis for a more legible display of our data. If we replace our date in the x-axis with month-year, this provides a better layout. In addition to our line chart, a table visual can be used to evaluate our year-over-year sales by dimension values. For our example, I can select state from our customer table, combined with our total sales, previous year sales, and year-over-year growth measures to display our sales growth by state. Here are some of the best practices and tips for year-over-year analysis in Power BI. First is a consistent date table. Ensure that your date table is complete and covers all necessary dates without gaps. Clear labels. Label your measures and axes clearly to avoid confusion. Contextual filters. Use slicers and filters to allow users to drill down into specific time periods. Anomalies and trends. Highlight significant trends and anomalies in your visualizations to provide deeper insights. Dynamic titles. Use DAX to create dynamic titles that reflect the selected time period. To conclude, mastering year-over-year analysis in Power BI allows you to uncover trends and insights that drive better decision-making. By setting up your data correctly, creating robust DAX measures, and visualizing effectively, you can leverage the full power of Power BI. I hope that you enjoyed this segment of Tips and Tricks.